हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मैथ्स ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 7th। टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑपरेशंस ऑन रैशनल नंबर्स। इन दिस वीडियो विल सॉल्व प्रैक्टिस सेट 22 क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। सो लेट्स बिगिन।
Rational numbers, it means just a fractions which has numerator and denominator. Only one condition is there, denominator should not be a zero. Any other number, if it will be there, then that fraction is called a rational numbers. For example, 12 upon 3, it has a numerator, it has a denominator. This is the example of rational number. Take another example, negative 7 upon 2. Here is numerator, here is denominator, which do not have a zero. If denominator is not a zero, then that fraction is a rational number. But if I will take 3 upon 0, then we cannot say this is a rational number. It's not a rational number. This is rational number. This is rational number, but it's not. As I said, denominator should be a non-zero digit. Zero should not be appear at the place of denominator. Understand the meaning of rational numbers. Now we have to learn operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. These are the basic core operations in mathematics. So we are going to solve the sums. Last year we have learned reciprocal or multiplicative inverse. Now forget about this number, okay? Just we'll see only these two numbers. If I ask you, tell me the multiplicative inverse of this number, it means you have to exchange the place of numerator and denominator. Where the numerator is there, their denominator we have to shift, and where denominator is there, their numerator we have to shift. Multiplicative inverse, it means we have to exchange the numbers. So 3 upon 12 is multiplicative inverse of 12 upon 3. Similarly, for negative 7 upon 2, we are not bothered about whether it is positive or negative. If it is positive, it will remain positive. If it is negative, it will remain negative. Don't change the sign. Okay, now 2 is there down, so we'll take this 2 up, and this 7 is there up, that we'll take it down. So these are multiplicative inverse of the given fractions. Now we will solve for practice set 22. So write down, have you written these examples? Write down these three fractions, put tick mark, put cross, so you will understand these are rational numbers and this is not. And two examples are multiplicative inverse of these two fractions. Write down practice set 22. Question number 1. Carry out the following additions of rational numbers. First one, 5 upon 36 plus 6 upon 42. We will take a LCM of these two denominators. So we will get the small numbers for calculations. Now take these two numbers here, 36 and 42. To find the factors, you first divide these two numbers by 2. So 2, how's the 36? 2, 18 is 36. 18 to the 36, and here 21 will come. 2 to the 4, 2, 1's are 2. Now these two numbers again are divisible by 3. Now 3 6's are 18 and 3 7's are 21. Further division is not possible, or both nothing is common in there. So what we will do? We will multiply 2 into 3 into 6 into 7. So that we will get LCM of 36 and 42. So write down LCM of 36 and 42 equals 2 into 3 into 6 into 7. 3 to the 6, 6 7s are 42. Now multiply here 42 with 6. Yes, 252 is multiplication of these numbers. Now to multiply 36 with what number, so we'll get here 252. Now if we see the multiplication of these three numbers, 3 to the 6 and 6 is the 36. So 36 into 7 equals, so we will get here 256. So that number is 7. And when we multiply 42 with a number that is 6, so we'll get here 252. So take this first fraction down, 5, increase the line that we have to multiply here upon 36, multiplication sign at both the places. And as I said, 36 multiplied by 7 equals 252. So multiply numerator as well as denominator by 7 equals. Already we know here this multiplication is 252, that is LCM. Now what is the multiplication of these two numbers?
35.
Yes, correct. 35 upon 252. This is the new fraction we got at the place of this. So put it's a point number one or fraction number one. Now take this similar second fraction down, 6 upon 42, multiply. Now when we multiply 42 with 6, we get here 252. So multiply with 6. So here 6 and here also 6, 36 by 252. And this will be your fraction number two. Now as we got equal denominators, we can add the numerators. So 35 upon 252 plus 36 by 252. Now tell me 35 plus 36, what is the answer?
71.
Correct. 71 and denominator 252 as it is, that is your final answer. Write down second sum. Now here mixed fraction is there, 1 and 2 by 3 plus 2 and 4 by 5. First we'll simplify in the form of numerator and denominator, and then we will add these two fractions. And we know that how to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction or simple fraction. We have to multiply these two and we have to add. So 3 1 the 3 plus 2, 5. So here 5 upon 3 plus 5 to the 10 plus 4, 14 by 5. These are the two improper fractions we got. And now directly do a cross multiplication. 5 into 5 plus 14 into 3 upon 3 into 5. 5 5 is the 25 plus 14, 3 is the how much? 42. 5 3 is the 15. Now add these 25 and 42. You will get 67 by 15. And that is our final answer.
That's all for this video. If you're visiting our channel first time, please subscribe to our channel as it's totally free, and press bell icon. Like and share this video. And finally, thanks for watching and supporting. God bless you all.